Hi there, this is Phil Vohl at D2L, and today we'll look at the consistent grading experience in Brightspace using the Quick Eval tool. Quick Eval is a tool that allows me to see all the different assessments that have been submitted across all the courses that I'm teaching as an instructor. You'll notice that I can access Quick Eval via a navigation bar link at the system level, and I also have a widget on the system homepage that allows me to easily see the different submissions that I need to assess. Now, in this case, if I look at this particular widget, you'll notice that there's an assignment called Your First Plan that has three new submissions within the Business 101 course. So we'll use this Quick Eval widget to assess an assignment, and then later we'll jump into the Quick Eval interface as well. When I come into Your First Plan activity to grade my first student here, what we'll see is that the student submission loads on the left three quarters of the page, whereas on the right quarter of the page, I have my assessment and feedback options. Now, when I scroll down to look at this particular student submission, what I'll see is I easily can view the submission itself. But if I need to maybe dive into the particular submission a little bit more, I can easily use our full screen toggle to toggle to a nice full screen mode. I also have the ability to zoom in or out on the particular submission and change its orientation. When viewing a student submission, you have some really powerful annotation functions that allow you to provide inline feedback on the student submission itself. As an example, what you'll notice is I have the ability to draw or freeform highlight the page. I can also use a text highlighter if there's certain text I'd like to highlight within the submission. As an example, I'll choose my text highlighter and I will highlight the text. In addition to highlighting text, I have the ability to add notes, text boxes, as well as shapes. Now, in this particular submission, I can see that there is a financial overview chart or graphic. And if I'd like to call something out within that particular graphic, I might opt to use the arrow shape to point at something within the graphic itself. As an example, I'll choose the arrow, and I will use this arrow to point towards the 2014 information. I have the ability to change the color of the arrow itself. I can change the thickness as well as the shape of the line. So very easy to change what that particular annotation looks like. In addition to the shapes, I also have the ability to add a text box as well as a note. So we'll start with the text box first. And just as an example, if I choose text, I simply can click anywhere on the submission and I can start typing. This is a great financial overview chart. I can select the text within the text box itself, and I can easily change the color of the text I've written. I also have the ability to change the font family as well as the size of the text itself. After you've added in your text annotation, I can easily move around the box as I see fit. I can also change the size of the box for the text itself as well. So it's very easy to use this particular text-based annotation. Furthermore, I can utilize notes, which is a really great way to add instant feedback to the submission itself. As an example, you can see that there are a variety of different shapes that I can utilize within my note, and the shape itself can provide that instant feedback to students. As an example, if there's a really great point, maybe for the highlights that are summarized here, I might choose the star and I might add that star to the page and then change the color maybe to yellow to make a nice star point. And I'll say, this is a great overview of the highlights. And this provides instant feedback to students in the sense that they simply can see the shape and the color, and that's going to allow them to see, okay, this is a great star point. And when they hover over that particular annotation, they can see the text that you've added or associated to that particular shape. Once you've added the annotations to the submission itself, I might toggle out of the full screen view. And what you'll notice here is that I have the easy ability to download or print the submission itself. So as the instructor, as well as the student, I can print the annotated version of this assignment itself, and I can use my download option to download the original or the annotated version of this document. So as an example, if you'd like students to review the annotations and the feedback you've provided and then resubmit, you might say, hey, CJ, please download the annotated version of the document, make some changes, and then resubmit. So it gives you that easy ability to create nice feedback loops. From an assessment standpoint, you'll notice that there is a rubric associated to this particular assignment folder, and I can easily just click into the rubric to assess CJ on his submission. Within this rubric itself, I can easily just hover over any of the levels within the rubric, and I can see quite clearly what a level 3, a level 2, or a level 1 is within this particular rubric. When you construct rubrics, you can have as many levels as you require, and you also have the ability to provide standardized feedback. In this case, I'll just simply click through the rubric to provide a score for CJ. And when I'm done clicking through and assessing with this rubric, you can see that the score is compiled and automatically saved. Now that rubric score will automatically flow into the associated grade item. In addition to the feedback we provide via the annotations as well as the marked up rubric, I can also use the overall feedback box to add additional feedback. As a simple example, I will say, great job, CJ. Beyond the text-based and piece of feedback we're adding here, I also have the ability to record audio, record video, add attachments from OneDrive or Google Drive, as well as upload files from my computer. And this gives you the ability to provide really powerful feedback in the form of various different media forms to our students. Now, if I'd like to publish the feedback and grade to the Business 101 course, I can simply click the publish button. Or if I prefer to grade all students before publishing those scores, I can use my save draft button and then the next button to grade the next student for the same assignment. Once I'm done grading all students for that particular activity, I can bulk publish the grade score as well as the feedback so that all students receive the score and feedback at the same time. In this case, I'll hit the publish button, and that is going to push the score and the feedback to CJ. He'll receive some notifications and he can see that information directly within his course. Now I'll use the back to quick eval button in the top left corner here to navigate to the quick eval tool. And within the quick eval tool, there are two different views. We have a submissions view as well as an activities view. Within the submissions view, I can see a list of all the student submissions to every assessment within all of those courses I'm teaching. And I have the ability to very easily use my filter and search capabilities to filter a search based on the activity name that I'd like to assess, based on the course I'd like to grade within, and even based on the date of student submission to the particular assessment. So this creates a nice grading queue that allows me to assess that student work. And if I'd like to assess, I simply just click in a student by clicking on their name, and that will open up that experience to grade. In this case, I'll click into Andy's name, and this will grade a discussion. What we'll notice here when the view pops up is that I can see the post that Andy has made within this poem draft discussion, and I can see the replies that she's made as well. You'll also notice that there is a rating scheme aligned to this particular discussion topic. Therefore, I can see the 5-star ratings that Andy has received on her various posts, and I can see the number of ratings as well. Very similar to that assignment experience, you'll notice that I have the ability to provide feedback and a grade via an associated rubric, as well as our overall feedback box. So again, you're getting that powerful consistency in assessment and feedback options from the various different assessment tools, such as assignments, as well as discussions. Finally, I'll come back to that quick eval tool and we'll take a view, or look, I should say, at the activities view within quick eval. When we look at the activities view, what we'll see is that the various different assessments that we need to grade are going to be automatically grouped based on the course that they're within. For example, I can see all of the Business 101 assessments, the discussion, the assignments, and the quizzes. If I scroll down, I can see Business 201. And if I keep going, I can see the sample course as well. As an example, I'll click into a quiz And when I click into the quiz to assess the particular quiz itself, what you'll notice is that Brightspace has already auto-graded the quiz. So you can easily set quizzes to be auto-graded by the system. And then as an instructor, you can come into this particular quiz grading view to either override the score or to provide additional feedback for each of the different questions within the quiz. So again, you can see we have this really powerful and consistent grading experience through the Quick Eval interface that allows you to efficiently grade and provide feedback to your students.